Thank you, Your Holiness. Now, Artigan, as to your concerns.
The Inquisition established an armed presence in Ferelden territory. You outright seized Kaer Bronach in Crestwood.
Yes, from bandits. Would you like us to give it back to them?
Your help was appreciated 2 years ago, Inquisitor. Now order has been restored, yet you remain. Invading under pretext of restoring order is exactly what the Grey Wardens did to us centuries ago, and we exiled them. Now the Inquisition is doing the same thing with Grey Wardens in their ranks.
Your concern is ill-founded. The Grey Wardens have proven their worth time and again.
Of course Orle tolerates this interference. The Inquisition is the only reason Gaspard sits upon the throne.
Rest assured, Tegan, the Empire of Orle will not stand idle if the Inquisition oversteps its bounds. Unlike Ferelden, however, Orle understands that these were the well-intentioned mistakes of a young organization.
An organization in need of a guiding hand. Yours, no doubt.
Pardon me, Inquisitor. Sister Leliana asked to speak with you in private.
My apologies. An urgent matter has come to my attention. Ambassador Montelier, can you handle this for a short while?
Of course, Inquisitor.
This is highly irregular.
Are we not even worth the Inquisitor's time?
Inquisitor, I thought you would want to see this. A Canary warrior in full armor. How did he get into the Winter Palace?
So, what would the Left Hand of the Divine see when she looked at this?
This is a warrior, not a spy. Part of the Antam, the Canary military. Most of his wounds come from a fight against someone using magic. But at least a few are from a blade. He was badly hurt, separated from his allies, and made it here before he died. But how?
Would the Iron Bull know anything about this?
I asked, and he is as surprised as we are. He says that if this were an official Canary operation, he would know. That suggests we're dealing with a rogue faction.
Huh. Deadly mysteries at the Winter Palace. Throw in a Hulla statue and some Caprice coins, and it's just like old times. Can Josephine manage the diplomats while I look around?
She will be fine. It's all speeches and posturing for the first few days anyway. I will ask Divine Victoria to call a recess for now. I will also have our friends ready themselves for battle if need be.
You think that's likely?
I think the Exalted Council may be more exciting than we expected.
If you care to leave.
It looks like he came down over the railing. Illuvian. If I'm going through it, I'm not going alone. Judging by the bloodstains, he tried to get through here.
What's wrong? That one doesn't like you?
This mirror doesn't look broken, but it's inactive. Maybe there's a way to unlock it.
Hey! trail leads to this mirror.
Right. Let's see where this guy came from.
Elven ruins. I'm not sure we're even in Orle anymore.
This is gonna be fun. The old team together again to kick some ass.
There's no throwing, right?
It was one time.
Another Kunari, dressed like the one in the Winter Palace.
He's Karashok, a foot soldier. Must have been in the same squad.
Whatever this is not our honeymoon. Just so you know.
The second best party of this whole affair.
Josie wanted me in a dress so foofed you could lose a ham in it.
Scorch marks everywhere. This is the work of a mage.
A powerful one. I can still feel the heat crackling.
We need to find out why these Kunari were here and who did this to them. Over there, Kunari. If we want to know why they're here, we've got to get across to that island.
Atishal Valen, Fenharam Aladadra.
The elves bound a spirit here. It feels old. Very old.
What does it want?
Nuvenas Menahelam. Tears Belasama.
I'm afraid I can't understand a word you're saying.
Birthama, Nadinan Sahib.
spirit considered us intruders.
Maybe it's all the intruding we did? When we intruded?
It must have been set to guard something. A letter by the Kunari. Why are they translating it into our language?
Kunari were living here. Why?
These Kunari were running when they died. Let's find where this battle began. Like Veilfire, it claimed this was a refuge for elven slaves.
Slaves? Of other elves? The old elves? Pissers.
This whole valley was a sanctuary created by the Dreadwolf Fenherel.
Fenherel? The Dalish elves' god of misfortune?
That alluvion only took us a short distance. That's the same lake we saw from the other tower.
Good for moving around a city, visiting friends, deploying guards. All over the back. He was killed by surprise.
This can't have happened too long ago. The blood's not even dry.
Here we go again. What a change of pace from the Winter Palace. A clear sky, a beautiful view, and yes, fields and fields of stripweed as far as the eye can see.
Stripweed.
Terrible stuff. Looks like grass, stings like a knife, and causes sores if you so much as brush against it. So, of course, everyone in Menrathus insists it makes a very decent tea.
Fen'Harel helping former slaves as a mortal, not a god.
Kinda curious that this guy had to specify he wasn't a god.
But Fenny helping is bonkers.
Fen'Harel sounds like quite the rebel. The old elven gods must have simply loved that.
The elven gods were just Evanyris, powerful, but completely mortal mages.
Whoever ran this place was trying to rebuild the slaves' confidence, get rid of old propaganda.
If that's true, Fen'Harel was teaching these freed slaves the truth about these false gods.
Right, boss?
It felt like the anchor stung me. This looks like it fits into that pedestal by the broken bridge.
This is creepy.
Sorry.
Why did those Qunari attack the Inquisition on sight?
No idea. They weren't Talvashar, though. This might be a rogue group, but they think they're following the Qun.
That's Fen Harel, removing the face markings from a Dalish elf.
Not Dalish. They weren't Dalish yet, right?
Maybe the markings used to have a different meaning. Weapons. These freed slaves actually fought back against the Evanuris posing as gods.
Interesting word, Evanuris. If all it means is mage leader, well, they were basically magisters.
The Dalish are going to shit themselves.
This letter says the Qunari came to these ruins because the Illuvians connect to Halam Shiral.
So they're aiming for the Winter Palace.
It was some sort of infiltration. There's no more details.
This is crazy. They're acting like we're at war.
Are they?
I don't know, boss. I wish I did.
Let's look for anything that explains why the Qunari came here before we go. A note about an unknown intruder coming through an Illuvian. They turned spirits against us, then fled.
It must be a mage. They killed any Qunari in the way and let the spirits do the rest.
Two parties, then. The Qunari, and a mystery agent determined to stop them. Come on, we have to warn people about the Qunari's designs on the Winter Palace.
One dead Qunari was bad enough. Now we have more, and they're hostile.
This makes no sense. The Inquisition has an alliance with the Qunari. Why would they attack us?
They also have no reason to be here, or using Illuvians at all.
I've had the mirror placed under guard for now.
It appears the relative peace and quiet of the last 2 years is coming to an end.
First the Blight, then mages and Templars, then Corypheus, and now this. Can't we go 10 years without the world falling to pieces?
We must ensure that the Qunari do not disrupt the negotiations. The Exalted Council is in a very delicate state.
I'm certain you can soothe the nobles' ruffled feathers while we solve the real problem.
Not when the Inquisitor insults everyone present by walking out in the middle of the talks. Our only advantage is that Orlais and Ferelden are divided in goal and grievance. If they unite against us, Divine Victoria will have no choice but to support their claims. We could lose everything.
Could we use the Qunari threat to remind everyone how valuable the Inquisition still is?
Not until we know more. It will be fine. I will attend to the Exalted Council.
And while Josie does that, we will investigate.
I'll head back to the crossroads. We need to find out what the Qunari are doing and why they attacked.
And I'll have a quiet word with our honor guard.